name is Lizzie Herrera, Program Associate in the Horticulture Department for the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture. Welcome to Part 4 of our RCA series on managing the rotating crossarm trellis and blackberry systems. In this video, we'll show you the traditional training of blackberries on an RCA trellis system using the method of primocane bending. The RCA trellis consists of a long arm and a short arm that can be rotated to different positions. Each arm has multiple horizontal wires between each frame that allow the primocane and floricane laterals to be attached to. Below the arms are two training wires where the primocanes will be trained horizontally. Floricanes are trained on the long arm, while the primocanes are trained on the short arm and later transferred back to the long arm. The standard or traditional method for training primocanes to the short arm requires bending the primocanes horizontally along a training wire. This method allows the lateral canes that form to grow vertically after the primocanes are tipped. In order to be successful with this method, growers must plan on training primocanes every few days, starting in the spring and continuing into early summer. In our example, we will be training on a trellis growing systems model of a rotating trellis. There are many different rotating trellis designs in manufacturers, as some do not include a short arm or may have a slightly different design. However, the general principles discussed in these videos should be applicable to most manufacturers' designs for movable or rotating trellises. In this video, we'll focus on the practices required for floricane fruiting blackberries that are in their second year or later. For more information on training first-year plants, check out Part 3 of our RCA series on setting up an RCA trellis system. The first step in getting started with this training method is selecting which primocanes to train, which will occur in the spring. It's recommended to train 2 to 3 primocanes per plant. When selecting primocanes, you want to look for canes that are healthy and have a good diameter. Canes that are too thin will produce weak laterals, while very thick primocanes are more prone to cracking later on. You also want to be aware of the location of the primocanes, and be sure to select ones that are coming up between the bottom two training wires. Some primocanes may come up on the long arm side of the trellis, and would be difficult to train around existing floricanes. Avoid training these canes as they will likely become damaged and will make removing floricanes more difficult. It's recommended to start this training process when the primocanes are 2 to 6 inches taller than the training wire on the short arm. If primocanes are too tall, it'll become difficult to bend them horizontally without breaking the cane. Starting primocane training and bending sometimes coincides with the time when the trellis is laid over in the bloom position. Growers will need to watch for primocane emergence to be sure to not miss the optimum window for primocane training. Now that you've chosen your primocanes, it's time to begin the horizontal training. First, take the tip of the primocane and gently bend and tie it to the training wire on the short arm side. In our example, we're using trellis clips, but there are multiple ways of attaching the canes to the wire. This part of the primocane will be soft, allowing them to be forced to grow horizontally. The direction in which you train your primocanes is up to you. Just be sure that all primocanes in the row are trained in the same direction. Because the bent primocanes will be moved from the training wire on the short arm to the training wire on the long arm, it's important to keep in mind that the cane should be kept in between the two training wires and not trained on the outside of these wires. Training outside of the training wire will make it more difficult to transfer the canes and laterals to the long arm in late summer to fall. Flexible tape is often used to secure the bent primocanes to the training wire. Be sure to not tie the primocanes too tightly to avoid girdling the canes. The primocanes will continue to need to be tied to the training wire as they grow. It's important to check on the primocanes bi-weekly as they will grow quickly and try to grow upward, making the horizontal training more difficult as the canes begin to harden. It's also recommended to train during the warmer part of the day, as the canes will be more flexible. Avoid training during cool mornings or during rainy weather to lessen the chances of a cane breaking. Some additional tips when training are to avoid tying the cane too close to the growing point, as the cane is very susceptible to breaking near the tip. Cane should also be bent in a gentle arc, not at a 90-degree angle. Once the cane has been bent and tied along the training wire, the lower leaves on the cane can be stripped from the bend down to the ground. Be sure to also break off any laterals that emerge from nodes below the bend, as these laterals may become difficult to train later. You will continue the bending and tying process until the primocane growth is just past the next adjacent plant. Once the primocane reaches this point, it's time to tip. Letting the cane grow just up to the next plant helps maximize canopy coverage in between plants. When tipping the primocanes, be sure to tip just above the next node. This will apply to all of the primocanes that are bent and trained. We've observed the best lateral cane production on the bent primocane near where the bend occurs, and less lateral production near the point of tipping. Applying a fungicide at tipping may be advisable to reduce the occurrence of cane dieback. The tipping of the primocanes will help promote lateral growth, which will eventually produce fruit the following year. As the laterals grow, be sure they remain on the top side of the short arm trellis wires and are not growing on the outside. We typically don't tie the laterals to the short arm, but use the short arm wires as support to keep laterals out of the row middle. Once the current season's dead floor canes are removed, the new lateral branches will be transferred to the long arm, which we'll cover in the last part of our RCA series. Tune in for part 5 of our RCA series, where we'll show you an alternative way of training blackberries on a rotating crossarm trellis. Be sure to visit www.uaex.uada.edu/RCA for additional information and resources on using a rotating crossarm trellis in Blackberry Systems. A special thank you to the Arkansas Department of Agriculture and the USDA Specialty Crop Block Grant Program for their support of this project. Thanks so much for watching!